Assalamu alaikum and a very good morning to all my wonderful students. Welcome back to subject English for class 7. Students, here we continue with unit 3. First, we have completed Gopal and the Hilsa Fish prose. Today, we'll start the Shade poem, which is written by Frank Flynn. So, first of all, students, take your Honeycomb textbook and open at page number 48. Now, students, the meaning of the shade is already written here. So, first of all, we'll see here, after we'll discuss related shade. Do you know what a shade is? A cow shade, a tool shade, a wood shade. For example, it's a small room away from the main house for storing or keeping things, animals, tools, vehicles, etc. So students, this is the meaning of the shade. What is shade? That the shade is a small room which is away from the main house, which is in the garden or in an open space, means which is away, which is far from the main house. Now main house means where you are living, where your family is living. So the shade is far from your house. And what's the use of this shade? It's used for storing or keeping things, animals, tools, vehicles, etc. Now things means which you are not using every day. Might be you need that things after means in a 1 month or after many days, etc. So the things which you are not using every day, that we have to store in a shade. Even animals, for the animals also we can use shade. Then to keep tools like garden tools, farm tools, etc. Then to keep vehicles also we can use shade. Ask your partner if she or he has ever seen a shade. Let her or him describe it to the class. Now students, we have already discussed it in live classes. Here this video is for those students who did not attend live class or because of some issue they skipped the live class. So they can see this video to understand this poem. Now I am having some pictures related to shade. Look at here, it's a shade which is away from the main house. It's look like a small room inside you can keep many things which is not, which we can use to keep things which we are not using every day. So the shade like this also. Now look at the next picture. Look at here, it's known as animal shade. Here the animal enjoy their food also. Even in this shade there is a facility for water also. So they are living here. Now look at, it's known as a tool shade. Might be the farm tools or garden tools, etc. So you can keep any tools in a shade. Now look at, it's a vehicle shade. Now look at, many cars are there under this shade. So this is known as shade, where you keep your things in a safe way, which gives the things, animals, safety. It's known as shade. Now let's move to the poem. So first of all, everybody take your pencil in your hand and look inside your textbook. Whenever you get any difficulty to understand of these words, so you can write there with a pencil that words which is explained by me. Now look at students, in this poem there are 4 stanza. Let's see the first stanza. Now look at this shade which is mentioned in the poem. There's a shade at the bottom of our garden with a spider's web hanging across the door. The hinges are rusty and creak in the wind. When I'm in bed, I lie and I listen. and open that door one day. Now, hear the poet Frank Flynn, who describing her own shade, which is at the bottom of garden. At the bottom of garden means at the end of the garden. Bottom, here you have to take the word at the bottom as an end of the garden. So here Frank Flynn is sharing her own experience, her own description of the shade, which is at the end of the garden. With the spider's web. Now spider's web means cobweb. Yes, it's a cobweb. Hanging across the door. Hanging means the cobweb is hanging on the door. Now look at here, this is a door. So here the poet is telling that the cobweb hanging means latakna. So they also made their home on the across the door, means everywhere across the door. The hinges are rusty and creak in the wind. Now hinges means joints. You know students, you can check at your home also. Look at your door. Your door is joined with one thing. It's known as hinges. It's joined with hinges. So it's known as hinges. You know, there is a one frame, and with the frame there is a one piece of wood or any other material which is joined with that frame. It's known as hinges. Are rusty. So here the poet is telling that the door hinges, the joints of the doors also become old and become rust. Rust means like junk lagna. It's a very old, that's why it's become rusty. And creak in the wind. Now creak is a sharp sound, very horrible sound. So creak is a sharp sound. So you can write with a pencil in your textbook. Creak is sharp sound, or you can say a very horrible sound. So when this horrible sound is coming, when the wind is blowing and passing through this door. When I'm in bed, I lie and I listen. And what this poet is telling, that the poet is not going near this shade. Actually, he observing this all thing from the house, which is far from this shade. So whenever she is going to sleep in the bed, that time she's listening and she's observing this all things. I'll open that door one day. But look at here, she was saying that a very sharp, very horrible sound is coming from this door due to the wind. But then also she's very curious to open this door one day. So in this first stanza, students, we have seen that the poet who described the shade which is at the end of her garden, after she was describing door, first of all, that the cobweb hanging across the door and the joints of the doors also become very rusty and it's making very sharp sound when the wind is blowing and passing through this door. She was observing this all things from her bed. She was listening everything from her bed. And she became very curious to know that what's inside this shade, who is making this noise and etc. So she was very curious and she's telling that one day I'll open the door of this shade. Now look at students, here I'm having pictures of the cobweb and it's known as the hinges. You can observe at your home also. Open and close your door so you can easily get this type of joints. It's known as hinges. Now let's move to the next page, page number 49. We continue with second stanza. That's a dusty old window around at the side with three cracked panes of glass. I often think that something staring at me each time that I pass. I'll peep through that window one day. Now students, in the first stanza, the poet was describing the door, the shade door. Now in the second stanza, she's continued describing the shade, but
the part of the window.
Now you can see in the first page, look at, after the door there is a window which is having three panes.
Three panes. Panes of glass means the sheets of glass, and three cracked. Cracked means broken. So here three sheets of glass there which are broken.
I often think that someone staring at me. Now staring means continuously watching.
To look continuously without the wink of eyes, it's known as to stare.
You know, sometimes what happens when we are watching some different things, we are watching continuously without the wink of eyes, it's known as staring. So note down in your textbook with a pencil that staring means continuously watching. So the poet is thinking that from the glass, whenever, each time that I pass
means
whenever I'm passing near this shade, I'm passing near this window, so I was thinking that someone is continuously watching to me.
I peep through that window one day. Now again the meaning of peep also look or watch, but staring means continuously watch.
So staring and peep is the same, but here staring means without the wink of eye someone is watching to you. So in this second stanza, students, the poet is telling that there is a window which is broken, the sheets of the glass are broken, as you can see in the picture, that it's the windows are broken, the glass are broken. And the poet was thinking that whenever I'm passing near this window, someone is watching continuously from this window. But still, she has some fear in her heart, but with this, she has some excitement also. She was thinking that someone is watching her, but then also she has confident, and you can say that she has a curiosity to open that window or to look from this window one day.
Now we'll continue with the third stanza. My brother says that's a ghost in the shade who hides under the rotten floorboards, and if I ever dare to set foot inside, he'll jump out and chop off my head, but I'll take a peek one day. Now here the poet is telling about her brother,
because in a first and second stanzas we have seen, students, that the poet was thinking herself only, that the cobwebs hanging on the door, then someone is making noise, the window is broken, and from this broken window someone is staring her continuously. But might be she has said these all things to her brother also. And what's her brother's opinion? She was sharing here in a third stanza that her brother says that's a ghost. Now ghost means spirit.
We are saying bhoot, it's known as ghost. Yes, it's known as spirit. So the poet's brother is telling her that one spirit, one ghost is living inside the shade, who hides under the rotten floorboards. Now under the rotten floorboards means, you know, students, that you can observe at your home also, there is a floor which has a tiles. But when you sprayed a carpet, might be it's a soft, but here rotten floorboards means which is made of some wooden stick. You can easily sit on it, you will not get hurt while sitting on it, but it's a hard than the soft like a velvet carpet. So it's a one kind of carpet only which we can spray it on a floor. So it's known as rotten floorboards. I hope it's clear to you. Rotten floorboards is a one kind of carpet which is made of wooden stick, which is very thin. You can easily sit on that carpet. And if I ever dare to set foot inside, and after what the poet's brother is telling to her, that if you will go inside and if you will just put your foot also, so what happened? He'll jump. Now here he is used for the ghost, that the ghost will jump on you and the ghost will chop off, means cut off your head. So here you can say that
The poet's brother is spreading fear on her that there is the one ghost is living. He's hiding himself under the carpet, and if you dare to go inside, if you will just put your one foot inside, you will not enter fully, but if you just put a one foot also, so what the ghost will do? The ghost will cut off your head. The ghost will jump on you and the ghost will cut off your head.
But I take a peek one day. Now look at students, if someone tell you like this that in this house or in this room ghost is living, have you dared to go inside and look inside? Definitely we are feeling fear. But here the poet's brother saying this all story about ghost. Even he's saying that if you will go inside, so he will cut off your head also. But then also you can say that the poet has too much dare, and the poet is a really bold girl. She now also want to peek inside the shade. Now again the meaning of peek is look. So students, in this poem we have seen many words for look.
As we know, look and watch and see, these three words are common which we are using. But which another word we have seen? Peek.
Then we have seen peep, and another word is staring. So in this poem we have learned many new words too. Now let's move to the fourth stanza. I know that there isn't really a ghost. My brother tells lights to keep the shade for his den. There isn't anyone staring or making strange noises. And the spider has been gone from his web. Since I don't know when, I'll go into that shade one day soon, but not just yet. So students, you can see that here completely opposite ideas, opposite thoughts are spread by the poet. We have seen in the three stanza that the poet might be confused or some fear is there in a poet. But look at in a fourth stanza, completely she forgot these all things and she decided to go inside this shade. And what she is saying in a third stanza, her brother told her that one ghost is living there, and might be the ghost will jump on you if you will go inside, and the jump will cut your head, and the he'll jump and cut your head. But here in a fourth stanza she was saying that I know that there is no spirit is living. And after in a second line, what she is saying, my brother tells lies, means the poet's brother is speaking untruth. The poet's brother is speaking lie. And why he's speaking lie? Here the poet is given reason also, that because he want to keep the shade for his den. Now the meaning of den means hiding place. You can write with the pencil there only. Den means hiding place. So the poet Frank Flynn is telling that her brother is speaking lie because while playing game, he want to hide himself in the shade. That's why he want to keep this as a hiding place only. There isn't anyone staring or making strange noise. Now staring. In a second stanza, the poet was telling that someone is staring from the window, yes? And in a first stanza, we have seen that the poet was telling that someone is making noise. Actually, whenever the wind is passing, that time through the hinges, which has become very rust. So from that the noise is coming. So here she is clear, she is making clear to us that nobody is making noise and nobody is watching me continuously. Even nobody is living inside like a ghost. And the spider has been gone. Now look at here, has been gone is showing present perfect tense. So the poet is telling that the spider also went away from the web, from the cobweb. Means there is no spider hanging on the door. Since I don't know when, and after what the poet is telling, I exactly don't know then on which time they went away. Means spiders went away from there. I'll go into that shade one day soon. Again she was telling
about her curiosity to watch and to look inside the shade that I'll go one day and I open that door one day, I see inside the shade one day, but not just yet. But at last, once again, she's saying the same things that not now only. Means you can say that in this poem, the poet might be very curious, but she has some fear also inside her heart. So students, I hope that this poem, it's clear to you and you definitely get interest in this poem. So in the next video now students, next video, we'll continue with the Grammar Get textbook. Still, if you have any doubts related to this poem or related any meaning, you can write in the comment box. So before next video start, I clear your doubts. Thank you all of you. Stay safe, stay healthy and have a wonderful day ahead.